Hi and assalamualaikum to Miss Muna and my fellow friends. Today, on behalf of my team members, my partner and I will present our findings on the grand strategy matrix. For your information, the grand strategy matrix has become a popular tool for formulating alternative strategies. All companies and divisions can be positioned in one of the grand strategy matrix four strategy quadrants. Moreover, this strategy is broken into four quadrants by an X and Y axis. Each quadrant represents a combination of a company's competitive position and growth of the market. The X-axis represents the company's competitive position, with the left side indicating weak competitiveness and the right indicating strong competitiveness. The Y-axis represents market growth, with the top half indicating rapid growth and the lower half indicating slow growth. In addition, any industry whose annual growth in sales exceeds 5% could be considered to have rapid growth. Appropriate strategies for an organization to consider are listed in sequential order of attractiveness in each quadrant of the grand strategy matrix. There are four quadrants that will be discussed, and now I will begin my explanation on quadrant 1. Organizations located in quadrant 1 of the grand strategy matrix are in excellent strategic position. The first quadrant refers to the firms or divisions with strong competitive position and operating in rapid market growth. Such firms and divisions are better to adopt and pursue strategies such as market development, market penetration, and product development. It is unwise for a quadrant 1 firm to shift notably from its established competitive advantages. When a quadrant 1 organization has excessive resources, then backward, forward, or horizontal integration may be effective strategies. When a quadrant 1 is too heavily committed to a single product, then related diversification may reduce the risk associated with a narrow product line. Quadrant 1 firms can afford to take advantage of external opportunities in several areas. They can take risks aggressively when necessary.
Next, I will explain on quadrant 2. Organizations in this quadrant 2 have a weak competitive position, but a rapid market growth. It refers to firms that need to work on improving their competitiveness. Organizations that lies in the second quadrant should evaluate its current strategy for the marketplace seriously. They should find out the reason why its current strategies are not effective enough to make it competitive in the market. The marketplace approach of quadrant 2 firms requires serious work and focused efforts. In return, businesses can boost their competitive approach. Besides that, organizations of the second quadrant should consider the intensive strategy as a first option, since they are in a rapid market growth industry. The suitable strategy includes market development, market penetrations, product development, horizontal integrations, divestiture, and liquidations. For example, when it comes to resource availability, businesses might look towards horizontal integrations. Besides that, some quadrant 2 firms, on the other hand, could expect stronger market growth than the firm's own. In addition to anticipating a highly competitive market, such companies tend to benefit the most from the disposal of some of their subsidiaries. Next, quadrant 3. Organizations positioned in quadrant 3 have a weak competitive positions and a slow market growth. These firms must make some drastic changes quickly to avoid further decline and possible liquidations. They have to do retrenchment through the extensive cost and asset reduction first. They should take an alternative strategy by doing diversifying, which is to shift resources away from the current business to into different areas. If all else fails, the final options for quadrant 3 businesses are divestiture and liquidation. And finally, the last quadrant, quadrant 4. Organizations have a strong competitive positions but a slow market growth. The firms under this quadrant have the strength to launch diversified programs into more promising growth areas. They also have characteristically high cash flow levels and limited internal growth needs and often can pursue related or unrelated diversification successfully. Lastly, quadrant 4, firms also may pursue joint ventures. That's all for Grand Strategy Matrix. Thank you for listening.